This is B. Naresh, working as Assistant Professor in EC Department. Today we are going to perform half-wave rectifier with and without filter. So by using this experiment, we are going to observe the ripple factor of half-wave rectifier with and without filter. For this case, the required components are like a transformer. So for this case, internally we require a semiconductor trainer kit, then diode, a PN junction diode, and load resistance devices like the analog vigilant discovery kit. By using this analog vigilant discovery kit, we need to measure the output voltage as well as the DC voltage as well as AC voltage. For this case, the required circuit diagram is, first we are going to perform half-wave rectifier without filter here, and this is the transformer. From the transformer secondary winding, we are going to connect to diode anode here. And the diode cathode is connected to ammeter positive, ammeter negative is connected to load resistance. Across this load resistance, we are going to measure the DC output voltage, AC output voltage, as well as the graphical representation of your, means the signal representation of this output voltage, that is nothing but your V0t. And this is the required circuit diagram for half-wave rectifier without filter. So now we are going to connect the circuit diagram as per the given circuit here.
Now we need to start the connections as per given circuit diagram, and here we need to take from the secondary winding of the transformer. And if you observe the semiconductor trainer kit, the bottom side, this is the secondary winding of a transformer here. So we need to take from this 12 volts. This 12 volts is connected to a diode anode here, and here first I'm going to place the diode, and this is the anode terminal and this is the cathode terminal. This white strip line is the cathode terminal and this is the anode terminal. And from this secondary winding of the transformer, 12 volts is connected to anode of the diode, and this cathode of diode is connected to ammeter positive. And ammeter negative is connected to load resistance here. And this is the ammeter negative. Ammeter negative is connected to load resistance positive. So for this case, I'm going to make them a node point. So by using this node point, I'm going to connect the ammeter negative as well as the load resistance positive. Then the load resistance negative is connected to ground potential. And here this 0 volts is also connected to ground potential. And across this load resistance, now we are going to measure the DC voltage, AC voltage, as well as the output representation here. So for this case, now we are going to use this analog Digilent discovery kit here. So by using this Digilent kit, now we are going to verify the output voltage. For this case, we required the CRO. The CRO means either we required channel 1 or your channel 2. Here I am going to place is channel 1. The channel 1 is connected across the load resistance here. And in the bottom bundle, this orange with a white line is connected to ground potential here. Then suppose if you want to measure the output voltage with respect to your input voltage, we can also connect the channel 2 here. So for this channel 2, in a top bundle, I use this blue color wire. This blue color wire is acts as a CRO channel 2 ends. This channel 2 I am going to place across the input side. Then we need to make the ground. So for this case, we need to take this black color with blue color with white strip, and it is connected to ground potential here. So these are the connections as per given circuit diagram here. Now we need to perform the experiment. Then to measure the DC voltage and the AC voltage, we required this multimeter here. By using this multimeter, we need to measure the DC voltage as well as the AC voltage for this rectifier. So hence here I'm going to play this volt multimeter parallel with load resistance. That is the reason I connected this positive wire is connected to positive of the load resistor, and the negative of this multimeter is connected to negative terminal of the load resistance. Now we need to apply the load resistance. Then, so by using this decay resistance box, we need to apply the load resistance. Then we need to observe the output voltage in terms of the DC as well as the AC. Then we need to measure the current here. So first, initially, I am going to adjust the load resistance is 500 ohms. For this case, first initially adjust it to all the knobs into zero position. Then by using this 100 ohms multiplication factor, by using this knob, I am going to place into 5 position. So hence, the knob is adjusted to 5 into 100 ohms, and the remaining all are in a zero position. The summation of this load resistance now it becomes your 100 ohms here. So with respect to this 500 ohms, now we need to measure a IDC value. This current is acts as a DC current, so we need to note down this DC current. Now here the IDC value shows that 14.0 or 14.1 milliamperes here. The ratings are milliamperes here. So with respect to this 500 ohms, the current is 14 milliamperes here. Now we need to verify the output waveform. For this case, we use this waveforms window in a desktop system. So first, click on this waveforms window. Then in that waveform window, you choose this scope. So here, this scope contains the two channels, C1 and C2. And C1 means channel 1, C2 means channel 2. And this is the blue color is the channel 2 wire, and orange is the channel 1 wire here. And here we place that this C1 is connected across the output node, C2 is connected across the input node, and input is your sinusoidal signal, and output is your, suppose I am removing this C2, this is the channel 1 output. So by using this response, we need to observe that means it allows only the either positive portion or your negative portion with respect to your diode connections here. So here it allows only the positive peak and attenuates the negative peak. So that is the reason this type of the rectifier is called as your half-wave rectifier. So by using this response, we need to observe the what is the output voltage. For this case, go to measure and select the channel 1, select the vertical, and in that select the maximum voltage. The maximum voltage is your 16.7. This is the V0. The output voltage of this is 16.75 volts here. Then we need to observe the DC voltage and the AC voltage by using this multimeter. Then switch on this multimeter, and here the one switch is there. By using this switch, we can adjust to DC side and as well as the AC side. Initially, I adjusted the DC side and put in the meter is a voltmeter. So under the DC condition, the DC voltage means this is the VDC value. We note down this VDC value here. VDC value is 5.37 volts. After this, then this knob shift towards AC node, then it shows a voltmeter reading, AC voltage, and this voltage is called as the VAC. Now VAC is the 6.76 volts here. So these are the parameters we need to note down by using this rectifier analysis here. After this, you change the load resistance by using the decay resistance box. Now by using this decay resistance box, now I am going to adjust to 1 kilo ohm by using this third knob. Initially, again I place all the knobs into zero position. Now by using this knob, I place into 1, multiplication factor is 1K, hence now the load resistance becomes 1 kilo ohm here. Now we need to observe the same parameters with respect to this 1 kilo ohm here. So then, due to this 1 kilo ohm, the DC current value, IDC value is 6.7 milliamperes. Now again, you verify this output waveform, there is no change in the response, but only the DC component and AC component values will be changes here. Again, output voltage is the same here, irrespective of the load resistance. Now coming to this multimeter side, first you note down the DC value, put in the DC node, the VDC value is 5.46 and the AC value, then put shift into AC node, then note down the AC value, the AC reading is 6.82 volts here. So similarly, after this, again you change the load resistance here. Then I am going to modify the load resistance. So now I am going to change this load resistance to 10 kilo ohms. So hence, again initially I place all the nodes into 0. Then I shifted to this one, second knob, and the multiplication factor is the 10K. Hence, the load resistance becomes the 10 kilo ohms here. Now due to this 10 kilo ohms, we need to observe the IDC parameter, VDC parameter, VAC parameter and the output voltage. So here this is the IDC value with respect to 10 kilo ohms. Now the IDC value is 0.7 milliamperes here. Note on this IDC value and similarly verify this output signal and there is no change in output signal. Again, the maximum output voltage is always irrespective of the load resistance, the output voltage becomes a constant. Then by using this multimeter, you note down the DC voltage and the AC voltage. First, I am placing the DC side and the DC voltage is 5.49 volts. Then note down the AC voltage by shift towards the AC side. Then it shows that AC voltage, the AC voltage is 6.92 volts here. So like this, we need to observe the rectifier analysis. So to this point, we observe the AC voltages as well as the DC voltage and the DC current with respect to the load resistance here. So by using these readings, we need to calculate the ripple factor, and we know that the ripple factor is, it is a ratio of AC voltage to the DC voltage here. So means that we observe the AC voltage as well as the DC voltage with respect to your load resistance. Then you calculate the ripple factor with respect to the load resistance by applying the formula is with the ratio of AC voltage to the DC voltage here. So then now again we are going to observe the half wave rectifier with filter here. So means that we need to reduce the AC components. We are going to use this filter concept here. So only the one more simple modification for this case, the half wave rectifier with filter, by adding the one capacitor across the load resistance, then it becomes your half wave rectifier with filter here. So this is actually half wave rectifier without filter here. So here, to perform the with filter test, we are going to add a capacitor parallel with this load resistance here. So hence, so here I added this 100 microfarad capacitor parallel with this load resistance, and the circuit becomes half wave rectifier with filter. Remaining everything is same here. So by using the circuit diagram, now we are going to connect the circuit. So here there is no modifications. Only the one modification. We are going to place a capacitor parallel with the load resistance. Remaining all the connections are same here. So hence, here I am going to place the 100 microfarad capacitor. So this positive terminal is of capacitor is connected to positive terminal of the load resistor. And negative terminal of the capacitor is also connected to negative terminal of load resistance here. Positive terminal is placed to positive terminal of the load resistance, negative terminal of the capacitor is connected to negative terminal of the load resistance, and the remaining all the connections are same, there is no modifications here. Now we need to observe the characteristics of this half wave rectifier with the filter, and the procedure is the same. By varying the load resistance, we need to observe the IDC value and the VDC value, VAC value, as well as the output signal here. So first, initially I am going to adjust the load resistance by using this decade resistance box. So initially I am going to place a 500 ohms. So for this case, this knob is adjusted to 5 and this multiplication factor is 100 ohms. Remaining all the knobs are in your zero position. Hence, now the load resistance becomes your 500 ohms. Now due to this 500 ohms, now we are going to observe what is the current, DC current, and what is the DC output voltage, what is the AC output voltage, as well as what is the output representation here. So here, and this meter shows the DC current value, IDC value with respect to this 500 ohms. Now the IDC value is 34.2 milliamps here. Now we need to note down by using this multimeter, we need to note down the DC voltage. The DC voltage is VDC value is 14 volts. Then you shift this button to AC side, then it gives the AC voltage. Now this AC voltage is 1.47 volts here. So by using this knob, we observe the VDC value as well as your VAC value. Now we need to verify the response of your half wave rectifier with filter. For this case, again go to this waveforms window here. Then select the scope, then open this window, then just you run this one. So now this is the response of half-wave rectifier with filter, means that this amount of the voltage DC level is adjusted here. So means that the AC ripples will be attenuated here. So here we need to note down that this maximum voltage, this is the maximum voltage and this is the minimum voltage here. So for this case, go to measure and use this add button, select the channel one vertical, select the maximum, and here the maximum shows that 16.486, and means that this is the 16.486 volts here. And the minimum, so minimum is, so means this point is minimum, this point is the minimum value is 11.546 volts here. So like this, so we need to perform the half-wave rectifier with filter with a different load resistances here. Now the second case, now I'm going to adjust the load resistance to 1 kilo ohm here. So for this case, I'm going to use this decay resistance box. Initially I'm adjusting to 0. Now I'm going to place the 1 kilo ohm, the load resistance, by using this knob, and the multiplication factor is the 1 kilo ohm. Remaining all the knobs should be 0 position. Hence the load resistance becomes 1 kilo ohm. For this 1 kilo ohm, now this meter shows the IDC value. The DC current is 18.3 milliamps here. 18.3 milliamps here. Now note down the, by using this multimeter, we need to note down the AC voltage as well as the DC voltage. Now the knob in AC position, hence this value shows that AC voltage 0.83 volts here. If you want to observe the DC voltage, shift this knob to DC position. Now this meter shows the DC voltage. The DC voltage is, VDC value is 15.3 volts here. So similarly, you can observe this for this load resistance and select this window again. Just you run this one. Then again you observe the, how this waveform will be shifted here. For this case also, we need to measure. Go to measure, select the channel one, again select the vertical, select the maximum. So maximum value is here. The maximum value shows that 16.6 volts, and select the minimum. Minimum value is your 13.76 volts. So means that, so this is the maximum value and this is your minimum value here. Then apart from that, again you can, another case, you change the load resistance here. Now the third case, I'm going to adjust the load resistance to 10 kilo ohms. For this case, initially I adjusted all the knobs to 0 position. Then by using this knob, I adjusted the load resistance to 10 kilo ohms. Now due to this 10 kilo ohms, now we need to observe the IDC value here. So now the DC current is, this meter shows that the DC current is 2 milliamperes here. Now the DC, by using this multimeter, the DC voltage is 16.7 volts. Then change this knob to AC load, and the AC voltage is 0.12. And similarly, here also we need to measure the output voltage. So now we observe this output response here. If you observe this output response, the load resistance changes, it removes the more AC components here. So like that, the complete, it becomes your straight line. It gives a perfect DC signal here. So here also, we need to measure the output voltage by using this measure, and select this channel one and use this vertical and choose the maximum. The maximum voltage is 16.79 and the minimum value is 16.42 volts here. So like this, we need to observe the, all the parameters here.
So up to this point, we observed the parameters like DC voltage, AC voltage and DC current for half-wave rectifier with and without filter. By using this, we are going to calculate the ripple factor of half-wave rectifier. By using the formula, it is a ratio of AC voltage to the DC voltage. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.